I came down here, and while the furnace was running, I checked here on the humidifier, and no water was coming out. And I made sure first that the humidifier, the dial was turned up, and you can hear it. You can hear it tick when it's going to turn on, so I knew I had it high enough. The second thing I checked was making sure that it was getting water. And I came up here to the saddle valve right here, and I made sure that was open, because sometimes somebody might have closed the valve and there's not enough water, but there was water coming from there. I came down to the side of the humidifier, and there's the pipe coming in, and I loosened that, and sure enough, water was coming out of there. The next thing is, while the unit was running, the furnace turned on and everything was running, I disconnected the wires and I hooked up my voltmeter. And I checked it. It's supposed to be getting on the side. It has all the information. It says 24 volts. And I turned it to voltage AC, I believe. I checked DC too, but AC I think is the right voltage. And it was saying zero while it was running. So this unit was not getting any voltage. It wasn't getting any power. So if it was getting power, it's probably just this orifice. You could just buy them for 20, 30, 40 bucks and put it on. It would be good. But it wasn't getting any voltage. So I know it was the controller was turned up enough. So it has something to do with this brown wire. So I looked all the way to the back in the circuit board. And I think I found the problem. I think I might have lucked out. So let me show you. So here's that brown wire that comes in. And it goes in through the side. And it comes down. And it goes to right here. And I think this is like a transformer that sends out the 24 volts, and sure enough, it's not connected. These wires right here are just dangling. I think what it is this is like a heavy transformer, and it just fell down. They had a zip tie here trying to hold it up, but I think it just came unplugged from the circuit board there. Now, if it was plugged in, this might be the culprit. This might be the bad unit, but since it's not plugged in, I think I can just connect it over here on the side where the two plugs are, and I think we should be good. So hopefully that's the case. I think I might have lucked out. Again, I had the power off when I'm working on it, but to test the voltage and everything, you have to have the power on and the furnace running. So hopefully I can just connect it up. But I was all worried. I'm like, oh, I got to buy a solenoid or a transformer or whatever it is. I don't know what it is. I've replaced an orifice before, and that's not a huge deal. And, they're 30, 40 bucks, but the transformer and electrical work and circuit boards I was a little nervous about, but seeing it laying there, I'm like, well, that's got to be it. So so before you call somebody out, and I'm not saying if you're not worried, I'm not great with electrical work, but I can see the two wires are dangling, they're not connected in. But if it was more than that, I might have called somebody out, or I might have bought that part, and if that didn't, I might have called somebody out. But just make sure your power's off and you're not touching anything and gonna electrocute yourself or do any more harm, like short out a circuit board or anything like that. But hopefully it's pretty simple. Water comes in, there's certain voltage that turns the motor on, and water through the filter. So you check the water, you check it's on there, you check it's getting voltage. I wasn't getting voltage. I traced it back to the circuit board. There's the transformer or whatever part that is down there. It wasn't plugged in. If it was plugged in, I would have replaced that part. So I hope this helps. I hope it demystifies some of the things you might be having if you're having the same problem. But we'll see. I'm going to go plug that in right now and connect all this up, turn the furnace on, and hopefully water comes out of the top here. Well, it took two tries, but it is now working. I thought there was only two wires that I could plug into on the circuit board. One was continuity and one was neutral. Turned out the neutral was correct, but there was another one on the circuit board called HUM for humidifier. So I connected black to HUM, the white to neutral, and I came back here to turn the furnace on, and I'm getting 23 volts to the orifice, and water is pouring out. So luckily I was able to fix it by myself. Again, if you're not sure, hire an electrician or an HVAC person to do it. I thought there was only two plugs, there was a couple more, so I was a little worried maybe I was going to have to replace the part, but I had it plugged into the wrong thing on the circuit board. But now it's working. I'm going to watch it, make sure everything is okay, but luckily I didn't have to buy anything, and it was a simple fix. So I hope this helps. Thanks.
Well, I hope you liked the video you just watched. If you did, feel free to subscribe by clicking the button on this side. You can also check out all the videos I've done, the playlist from things I've built, things I've fixed, home repair, 3D printing. And on this side, you can check out a recommended video similar to the one you just watched. And as always, down in the description, I'll put a link to my blog, which has more pictures and more information about the video you just watched. Thanks.